Back now at 8:11 in this morning on our special series, Together Again, Favorite Movie Cast Reunited. It is the 1980 box office smash Airplane, a regular on most lists of the funniest movies ever. Airplane has become a cult classic with some of the most memorable zingers of all time.
Flight 209er clear for Vector 324.
We have clearance, Clarence.
Roger, Roger. What's our vector, Victor?
With a captain named Over and a co-pilot named Roger, you know this will be no ordinary flight.
Roger.
Airplane parodies disaster movies and follows the plight of passengers and crew who fall deathly ill after eating bad fish. Their only hope, Ted Stryker, who hasn't flown since a traumatic crash in an unidentified war.
There's been a little problem in the cockpit.
The cockpit? What is it?
It's the little room in the front of the plane where the pilots sit. That's not important right now.
At the helm, not comedians, but actors, who played their tough guy images for laughs.
I got picked the wrong week to quit drinking.
The late Lloyd Bridges. And Robert Stack in the control tower. Mission Impossible's Peter Graves as captain.
Joey, have you ever been in a Turkish prison?
And Leslie Nielsen as Dr. Rumack.
Captain, how soon can you land? I can't tell. You can tell me I'm a doctor.
Airplane Sight. Would launch Nielsen's comedic career.
The other two pilots are just fine. Can you fly this plane and land it?
Surely you can't be serious.
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley.
Robert Hayes and Julie Haggerty played star-crossed lovers. Joined by a host of famous faces.
I know you. You're Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. You play basketball for the Los Angeles Lakers.
I'm sorry, son, but you must have me confused with someone else.
Add the Love Boat's Jill Whelan. One river. And Barbara Billingsley from Leave It to Beaver, Talk and Jive.
Just hang loose, blood. She's going to catch up on a rebound out of Mensa.
While those aboard Flight 209 screamed, their audience screamed with laughter. Well, that was then, and this is now. Leslie Nielsen played Dr. Rumack. Peter Graves was Captain Over. His co-pilot was basketball legend Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Joey was right. He played Roger Murdoch, and Jill Whelan was the sick little girl. And in L.A. this morning, Robert Hayes, a.k.a. Ted Stryker. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
Happy to have you.
Yeah, great to have you. And we're laughing hysterically. We've all seen the movie a million times. I was thinking, what do you think is the appeal of this movie? It doesn't matter how many times you see it.
It's just the nature of the humor, because they never tried to tell anybody what was funny. They just put it up there, and if you missed it, you had to see it a second time and catch it.
And you always played it straight, so.
Oh, yeah, you had to. Otherwise, you could not show that you were aware of the joke. Because in comedy, the moment the audience sees that you or know what the joke is, then it's over. They're not going to laugh.
And Peter, you actually turned the role down in the beginning when you first offered it.
I didn't turn it down.
You were upset. You said it was trash.
Oh, I read the script and threw it across the room. I said, this is insane. And not only that, it's the worst taste I've ever seen from any piece of material. And then I started thinking about it. And I said, this could be funny, but now wait a minute. This is old Iron Pants from Mission Impossible and Fury and all that stuff. How are audiences going to buy this from me? And I couldn't believe it. And I told my agent no, and he said, okay. And I got a call 10 minutes later from Howard Koch, the godfather of Hollywood. And he said, why don't you come in and meet these young guys? Because you'll get something from them. And I did, of course, and that was that. Crossed fingers and did all that stuff, but I went for it. And when we went to that first showing at the Directors Guild, and in 5 minutes, they're all falling down and clutching their sides. And I said, geez, I'm funny.
Phew. Right? So, why did you, you're a big basketball star at that point with the LA Lakers. Why did you want to take this leap?
Well, I thought that I had come across the wrong way to the public, and it really was a great opportunity for me to poke fun at my image. and just get people to laugh about a few things. I'd taken my career so seriously and was so focused on it, people didn't think I could do anything else. So it was a great opportunity for me.
And he wanted to be my co-pilot.
That's right.
You've got a lot to cover when you want to poke fun at your image.
It's pretty long. Yeah. Robert, this was your first movie. What was this like on the set for you, your first big movie, starring movie? What was it like for you?
Well, it was very exciting. It was being thrown out there with a lot of people that you had seen before, Leslie and Peter. Very interesting. And Leslie's machine. Which I have to tell you, that's amazing when they come in for your close-up, and Leslie is farting away with that little machine in the background.
Don't be a crybaby.
So having to keep a straight face, that was the challenge. But this was so much fun. If you can imagine going to work and laughing every day, it was really, really fun. And I got to say, I haven't seen Jill for many years, and holy smokes, she's grown up.
Yeah, Jill, that seems to be everybody's reaction, that you've grown up.
I know. That's, age and all.
How did you audition for that part? Did you have to audition as if you just had the thing pulled out of your arm and that face, the whole mugging? And
I did. I went to Howard Koch's office, and I was just a little thing. And I remember most being impressed by when I went to his door, I thought, oh, I have to do this movie. He's got a gold door. And it was this huge, do you guys remember that massive gold door in his office? I was totally impressed. And he had me lay on his couch, and he said, okay, make a funny face. And that was my idea.
And that was it. But at the time, you said either this is going to be a major hit or the biggest flop they've ever seen.
Yeah, there was no going in the middle. It was either one or the other.
And while you were doing this movie, did you think it was funny? Did you really? I mean, were you guys laughing at this stuff?
I was laughing at it myself. I really enjoyed it, but I never knew it was as funny as it really was. I went to see a screening, and I hear people laughing. I'm in the scene, and
we're running out of time.
What are they laughing at? Because I did not know, and I was doing things that were funny, and I couldn't see it when I know.
Did you realize that line surely was going to stick with you forever and ever and ever?
The moment that it came out, Howard Koch came back, and he says, "Well, I guess that's going to be it, Leslie." Don't call me Shirley. It's going to be with you. And it's amazing. And it's amazing because today the picture never loses its effect and its fun. And so there are so many young people growing up, 10, 11, 12, and they're getting this picture for the first time. So I'm getting a lot of don't call me Shirley. Excuse me.
It's okay. No.
I just,
it means you're regular.
Robert Stack and Lloyd Bridges no longer with us. Having these two giants of the screen, but we're always for playing it straight and the tough guys, what was it like with them on the set?
Well, it's funny that you should ask me that because I never worked with them. I was always in the cockpit
scenes, right?
Or being carried out after having eaten
the fish.
So I have a feeling that all of us guys who had played a lot of straight stuff on the screen were concerned as to whether it was going to be funny or not. One of the nice things now is that the one audience that I see who really enjoys it the most are the airline crews. And they're fabulous. And every time I get on an airplane, they say, "Hi, good morning." You, whoop. Captain, come here.
I was in Europe and flying on one of those very big planes that had a lot of extra seats for the crew.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the crew, the pilots came and made me get out of my seat and get in the cockpit with them and take off with them so that they could say that they flew with Murdoch.
Fun. There are so many great lines in this movie, and I don't know if you have a favorite, but I'm going to put you all on the spot. Beginning with you, Robert, what is your favorite line from the movie?
Oh, holy smokes, there are so many of them, but you had a partial clip of one of them. When Leslie and Peter are right behind the cockpit in that area, and they're saying, "How long before you can land? I can't tell you, I'm a doctor." I can't tell you. You can tell me I'm a doctor. That one. And there's so many.
I still use that.
That's a good one. Jill?
Again, there's so many of them. I guess I picked the wrong time to stop sniffing glue. Something I use when my children are around.
Great.
People always ask me, come on, give us one of those lines, and I have to we have Clarence Clarence. I mean, I've got to say it. You know, they won't let me go. You know?
Yeah, that's right. The Clarence Clarence, and then I have to answer him with, what's our vector, Victor?
Mm-hmm. Roger, Roger.
And then, incredible.
But how do you keep, I mean, you're playing opposite that little boy for a while, saying things, have you ever seen a grown man naked? You know, I mean, that, and you're not laughing. I don't know how you did it. That was hard.
That was difficult.
Yeah.
Let me tell you. I was once standing in a supermarket line checking out, and ahead of me is a nice lady. She's checking out. She's got about a 12-year-old boy with her who's looking up at me like maybe he's seen me somewhere, but he's not sure. And she casts a glance, and she's not either. But then she finished her business, and the kid's still looking at me. And I just leaned down and said, son, do you like movies about gladiators? She grabbed that kid.
Had never seen the movie.
Nobody had seen her since.
And Leslie, you'll have the final word here. Favorite line? Yeah. Or whatever sound you want to make.
The final word, but I want to take the final word with the, which I think was one of the funniest jokes.
Well, hold
me.
That thought. We'll be back in a minute.
Right after these messages.
And look who we brought outside to the plaza, the gang from Airplane, Leslie Nielsen, Peter Graves, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Jill Whelan, and in Los Angeles, Robert Hayes. And we cut you off, Leslie, right as you were about to say what your favorite line.
One of my favorite lines was in when I was in the office talking with Priscilla. And I happened to glance down and I saw that she had this bracelet around her ankle. And I said, that's really a good-looking bracelet. She says, oh, did that slip down again?
Oh, that's actually from Naked Gun.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
From Airplane.
No, I have to be careful.
Okay.
All righty, then. Robert, can I ask you about Julie Haggerty? Could not be here today, but do you keep in touch with her?
Occasionally. I mean, it's long between hellos, but I was in the restaurant just not too long ago, and they said that Julie had just been in with her husband. And so I said, oh, well, is she coming back? And they said, yes. So tell her hello. So we say hello to each other that way, but she's just the best. She's just absolutely wonderful.
She was terrific in the film as well.
And of course, we were trying to get Autopilot, but he just wouldn't show up.
I know. And also, I forgot to mention, Ethel Merman was also
in this
film. I mean, we had some great cameo appearances as well. So
I think my all-time favorite. Johnny, what can you make of this? I can make a hat
or a brooch or a pterodactyl.
And Stephen Stucker.
Stephen Stucker, yeah, the late Stephen Stucker. Right.
Well, thanks for giving us so many great
so many
years.
In fact, our Lenny has a shirt on. Hi, stewardess. Hey. I speak Josh.
Hey. That's awesome.
And the best to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so
thanks
much.
For joining us.